I want to know how you managed to give them all such deep storylines. You're not letting fall behind.
It's just a big, like, those people who can, like, spin plates on sticks. But, like, I can't wait till the day it all comes crashing down and you're, like, asterisk to my question. I just really love all the characters, and I think on a show that is maybe a little bit of an underdog show like ours does, I always say, like, we have, like, Game of Thrones, like, cut-up veggie budget, do you know what I mean, for the entire run of our show. You really need character to be consistent and be developed and act in character. I think that's, like, my one rule. I have, like, no rules in writing. I'll try it all. My writers kind of know that, but I'm, like, I really think the character needs to act the way dolls would act versus the way Waverly would act, even if it makes story harder or the challenge is harder. I think the audience has bought into that. That's kind of the covenant you've made with the audience. So I just like my characters three-dimensional. I think it's just so much more rich, you know? So thank God we don't have a cast of thousands. That would be a nightmare. No, come on in. You arrived for the best. It's totally fine. Yeah, you skipped. Thank God you skipped Tim Rose on Nightmare. Oh, I know. Nice to see you. How you doing?
Nice to see you too. Yeah. So this is probably one of the most feminist.
Sure.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
How do you approach writing? You're very much so. How do you approach it as you're writing?
I just trick everybody. Like, I honestly just kind of, like, threw so many female characters, and, like, Lupato just didn't have a first name, and then, like, you cast it as a woman. You just cast it as a woman. I really think Sci-Fi, the network, deserves credit. They have not once said to me, like, can you tone it down with the vagina talk? I think genre, as a rule, is really inclusive, right? Since the time of Star Trek, it, you know, certainly hopeful genre portrays a world that we want to live in, one that celebrates diversity and equality. So I almost think it's easier in genre to kind of comment on that stuff. And really, I didn't pull any punches. Like, when I pitched the show, I was like, I want to do a Western, but with all the traditional male characters as women. So I don't feel like I've tricked anybody. I don't know, it's just really important to me. I've never written on a show without a female protagonist. It's just kind of been my privilege in my writing life. And now I feel like it's kind of my jam. So it's working out okay, I hope, yeah.
So leading up to the Game Changer episode,
yes,
there's a lot of Plan B jokes.
Yes.
Dropping those as hits.
Oh, yeah, constantly. Well, also just to make Melanie Scofetta laugh her head off in the read-through, because she doesn't read the script ahead of time. So, like, she's got a good, like, dirty sense of humor. So, like, definitely the pregnant lady is going to like a good abortion or plan joke. So, yeah, a little bit. I really, though, wanted to keep it a secret. So I didn't do a lot of the traditional stuff you see on shows with, like, there was no morning sickness or, like, you know, I tried to keep it as steady as it happened, because I really wanted it to be as big a surprise for Wynonna as it was for the fans. It is honestly a miracle in this day and age we kept that a secret, though. Like, it's funny, too, like, for our younger fans, obviously I'm only 24, no, but I just remember, like, in my day, in the cave with my dinosaur, we didn't have the internet, so, like, we didn't get spoilers, but I feel like spoilers are so much a part of everyday culture, and if you're a rabid fan, it's hard to avoid them, right? You think you want to know, even though you might not want to. So what an amazing gift for the audience that so many of the fans were surprised. We were all in it together when we found out. And also, what a testament to the cast and crew that everybody kept it quiet. Like, it just speaks to the love we have on set and the respect we have for Melanie, I think, that everybody just really took it seriously. But sure, I wanted to do it, but I didn't actually think we'd pull it off, so, yeah.
The decision to make the pregnancy progression so quick in that one episode,
oh yeah,
like, was that always the plan to get her from point A to point B?
Nothing was always the plan, because once the pregnancy happened, you're like, ah! But honestly, when we did the math of how far along Beth was, we're like, and of course she still looks amazing, but we're like, she is 7 months here, so, like, she gave birth 4 days after we packed, so it was like a miracle we made it, which is also part of the reason we knew we had to incorporate the pregnancy, because we're like, she's 9 months, but this isn't a sitcom. I just can't have her holding an increasingly large series of laundry baskets, you know, like, I want her to kick some ass. So I was proud of that episode. I mean, it's a bit of a supernatural genre trick, but it was all done in good faith, and, like, if you know that trope, I hope you get that it's a little bit of a wink. So, yeah, it was fun. And also, like,
to be honest, just talking about the type of character Wynonna is, she's like single, she's an, you know, a borderline alcoholic. Do I think she would keep the baby if she had a choice with the fate that it her bearer? No, and as a feminist show, I think that choice needs to be put on the table. But I also think so much of the theme of the show is like, she, destiny keeps screwing over Wynonna and not giving her a choice, but every day she gets up and she's like, I'm still gonna fight to make the choice I want wherever I can. So it all kind of came together. Plus a Sandman.
Yeah. Have you thought about season 3? Or are you
constantly. But like, if we get a season 3, I will have like a minute of elation and then like immediate panic, right? Which is like, as soon as you lose that fear as a writer, you're dead. Every season, I look back at the season before and I'm like, how did past Emily do that? I don't remember how to do this. So yeah, I'll keep telling these stories as long as you all let me. And even if you try to stop me, I'll show up at Sci-Fi's door and be like, here are the scripts. They'll be like, yeah, we didn't order this.
So you worked at Lost Girl and you had to work around Anna's pregnancy.
Yes.
Did you learn any lessons from that? She was just on the train.
She was. You know, the slight difference with Lost Girl is Anna was just pregnant in the finale. So, like, she wasn't showing. She had the baby between seasons, and then she just needed a bit of time at the beginning of the next season. So certainly I wasn't a stranger to working around pregnancies, but this was like the full kit and caboodle. Like, God bless Melanie, but the timing could not have been more crazy. So, you know, I think that's the truth, though. You have to put your money where your mouth is. I've had two kids in this industry. When you cast actresses of a certain age, sometimes people want to have kids. So you just need to be prepared to honor those commitments. If you say you're a feminist, I think you have to try to figure it out. Please don't let Dom and Kat get pregnant. I'm just saying that, just in case. Yeah. Just kidding. Yeah. Challenge accepted.
Can we expect any surprise pairings by the end of the season?
You can. Yes. and on all cliffhanger endings from here on out. It's crazy.
You really brought it last night.
That was nothing. That was a soft landing. Yes. Yes, I would say so. I think the cast is so strong. One of my favorite things to do is I like exploring weird relationships. I want to know what Dolls and Nicole is like, or, you know, Doc and Nedley. I like to do it all, and the cast is so strong. I feel like that's really fun, you know, to put two characters together and be like, okay, workplace, what are they like without Wynonna, you know, and stuff like that. So, yeah.
And we'll be spending a little time exploring some backstories too.
Yeah, I think so. Next episode for sure. We learn a little bit more about the Earp curse through a very interesting device. And of course, we have to figure out if Waverly's really an Earp or not. So, yes.